In this video, I'm going to go over what is called interval notation. It's a different way of writing an inequality and graphing an inequality. So let's start off with this problem. X is greater than or equal to 1. This is more standard notation. And if I were to graph that, it says X is greater than or equal to 1. So that means it's equal to 1, so I put a dot on 1. And then it said it also can be greater than. So I draw an arrow to the right. And that's one way of graphing x is greater than or equal to 1. Now, there's a completely different notation. It looks similar, where you show using either parentheses or brackets the smallest number and the largest number in the inequality. So in this particular problem, the smallest number is actually 1. And if it actually is equal to 1, what we do is we start off with a bracket. So you're going to either use a parentheses or a bracket. I'll explain the parentheses in a minute. A bracket means this is the very smallest number of the solution, 1. And then notice it goes on forever, though there is no highest number. But if you go infinitely to the right, you have to imagine, well, what number could that be? There is none. We'll just say infinity, and we use a open parentheses to show it doesn't really land on a specific number. It keeps on going forever and ever to infinity. And infinity looks like a sideways 8. Okay, now how would I graph this using interval notation? Well, if it goes infinitely to the right, and the smallest number is 1, what we'll do is at 1, we'll put the bracket going the same way. So we have a bracket right at 1 showing it's opening to the right, and then we do the exact same thing with an arrow going to the right. So this is a way of showing x is greater than or equal 1 using interval notation. All right, now what if instead of it being greater than or equal to 1, it was just greater than something? Let's do one like that. Let's say the problem was x was greater than negative 2. All right, so what's the smallest number it can be? Well, you know, it's greater than negative 2. There's no smallest number just to the right, right? So this one's a little bit tricky, but when you were using the older notation, what we do is put a circle on negative 2 to show it doesn't exactly touch negative 2, and then we would just draw an arrow going to the right. Okay, so the difference is instead of a dot, we'll put a circle. Circle means negative 2 is not part of the solution. All right, now for interval notation, what's the smallest number? Well, there is no smallest number. If there is no smallest number, then we use a parentheses. So this means it goes almost to negative 2. Okay, to the left, of course, it hits almost negative 2. And then I go to the right. And again, I'm going all the way forever to the right. I'm going to use infinity and a parentheses. Anytime you're dealing with infinity all the way to the right or negative infinity all the way to the left, we're going to use a parentheses next to infinity. Also in interval notation, you put the smaller number on the left and the larger number or infinity on the right. So how would we graph this? Instead of using the bracket on negative 2, we're going to use the parentheses on negative 2, and then we'll go to the right. So it looks similar, right? Instead of in open circle, we'll use the parentheses. It sort of matches what it looks like over here. And let's see, by the way, might want to just make this the same color, matching it up. All right, so now let's do one where it's like less than. It's going to be exactly the same, except the arrow will be going to the left. So here's another example. Let's say I wanted x is less than 3. All right, now notice 3 is not a solution. So in my usual notation, I'm going to use a circle because it doesn't exactly touch 3. And then I want all the numbers to the left of 3, right? X is less than 3, so I need to go to the left with my arrow. Okay, so this is the usual notation most students first learn. And now what we want to do is how am I going to write this using interval notation? All right, so I want numbers to the left of 3. So look at the picture here. It's going to the left forever. So what's the very smallest number? Well, there is no smallest number. So we call that negative infinity, and so we're going to have to use a parenthesis. Negative infinity, and it's going to go all the way until 3, but not exactly touch it. So it goes up to 3, and since it doesn't touch it, we put a parenthesis around it. All right, so now let's do the matching interval notation. Instead of a circle, it's going to be a parenthesis opening the same way, right, as where it is over here with the 3. And we're going to the left forever. So there's the interval notation way of writing the inequality and the graph. Now notice this looks like an ordered pair. It is not. It's sort of like you have to take it in context. Just like if you look at a certain word, like this word, and I asked you, how would you say that? How would you pronounce it? One person might say read, and another person might say read. It's all in context of the sentence it's in. It's the same thing here. You have to take it into context. We're talking about a solution in interval notation, inequalities, so this is not an ordered pair. Also, the infinity is a clue that something's strange. But we are going to do some other problems where there'll be two numbers and it really does look like an ordered pair and it's not. So here's an example like that. What if I had that x was between negative 1 and positive 3, and in fact this is red. Negative 1 is less than x is less than or equal to 3. So if we want to graph this the usual way, right, it says x is really sandwiched between negative 1 and 3, but it doesn't exactly equal negative 1. It's a little bit bigger than negative 1, so I have to put the circle on negative 1, but it actually goes all the way up to up to positive 3. So we fill in between those numbers. Those are numbers that are bigger than negative 1 and go all the way up to and including 3. So now, how am I going to write that in interval notation? Okay, well, if it's sandwiched between two numbers, actually it's kind of easy. You're going to write those two numbers in order, smallest number on the left. And if it does not have an equal sign, there's going to be a parenthesis. And if it does have an equal sign, it's going to have brackets. So that's how you would write negative 1 is less than x is less than or equal to 3 using the interval notation. So let's see what that looks like on a graph. It matches up really quite nicely. All right, so we have the same type of thing going on. At negative 1, you have the open parentheses, and at 3, you have the bracket, and then you fill in. Get your solution. All right, so that's basically how you would use interval notation. And what's nice is it's a little bit shorter to write. It's you know, to write the negative 1, 3 this way as opposed to writing negative 1 is less than x is less than or equal to 3. So this is just another notation that you commonly use when you're trying to write a solution set with inequalities. Keep in mind that if this was negative 1 is less than x is less than 3, you would have had a parenthesis instead of a bracket next to the 3, and that's what I'm talking about. It would really look just like an ordered pair, negative 1, 3, but it's not because it's in context. We're talking about how to write a solution to an inequality. So you just have to keep in mind what you're writing. All right, one last thing. What if you wanted the entire number line to be your answer? That would be negative infinity to positive infinity, and you always use parentheses, and the way this would look on a graph, you know, let's say that's negative 5 and 5, for instance, is it's just the whole thing. the whole graph. So if you've got the whole graph, the whole number line, it's just between negative infinity and positive infinity. Let's do this in general. We'll assume A is less than B. Let's say we were given these inequalities, X is less than A. This is what the graph would look like in interval notation, and this is what the interval notation would look like for these four possibilities. We have these other possibilities where X is squished between two numbers. And I see I forgot to put that there. And so that's it in general.